Hello everyone, welcome to Daily Current Affairs series. Today we will discuss about 5th August current affairs. Myself Sunny Sandeep, welcome to my channel Gear Up for Group 1 Exam. Let us discuss that today's important current affairs, that is Ayodhya awaits Modi's launch of Ram Temple construction. Here we have to see the dispute, that is Ayodhya dispute timeline. Here if you see in 1528, that is inscription say Mughal Emperor Babur ordered construction place called Janmasthan Masjid till 1940. Hindus say temple demolished to build the mosque. Here if you see 1949, that is the government declares the premises as a disputed area after idol of Lord Rama surfaces inside the mosque. Muslim protest. Here after 1949, in 1961, UP Sunni Central Waqf Board files a suit demanding the possession of idols, possession of site and removal of idols. After that, 1986, locks removed after district judge's order, the site opened for the Hindus for worship. Here, 1992, that is, Karsevaks demolished the Babri Masjid 2000 plus dead across the India in the triodes. If you see in 2010, Allahabad High Court orders awards 2/3 of disputed area to Hindu parties and 1/3 to the Waqf Board. In 2018, that is, SC refuses to reconsider the observations in 1994 judgment that mosques are not integral to Islam. If you see in 2019, that is, SC holds day-to-day hearings in the Ayodhya case after mediation efforts fails. Finally, Supreme Court ordered to construct a Ayodhya temple, Rama temple in Ayodhya. Next one, World Breastfeeding Week, that is WBW. World Breastfeeding Week is annually held from 1 to 7th August. To promote the exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months of life, which has huge health benefits. World Alliance for Breastfeeding Action, WABA, World Health Organization and United Nations, UNICEF. Here it was first celebrated in 1992, after that it is celebrating on. Here there are many benefits from the breastfeeding. For a baby child, we have to give the breast milk only to that baby. Then only that baby inherit their good benefits from that one. That's why to promote exclusive breastfeeding for the first 6 months of that life of baby. Next one, Barak Nuclear Power Plant. Here the Barak Nuclear Power Plant is the United Emirates' first nuclear power station. It is the first commercial nuclear power station in the Arab world. It is situated at the AI Darfan region of Abu Dhabi. It consists of 4 APR 1400 nuclear reactors. 1 is operational and 3 mostly completed. The plant powered by the South Korean technology. This Barak Nuclear power plant is powered by the South Korean technology. Hopes to produce 5.6 gigawatts of electricity and supply up to 25% of the UAE's electricity needs. From this one, that United Arab Emirates will get the 5.6 gigawatts of electricity and supply to the 25% of the UAE's electricity needs. That's why it is a first commercial nuclear power plant station in a Arab world, like Iran, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, UAE. These are the Arab world countries. That's why the first commercial nuclear power station in the Arab world. Next one, a famous person, that is Ibrahim Al-Qaizi. Ibrahim Al-Qaizi, he born in 1925, he died in yesterday 2020, was an Indian theater director and a drama teacher. He is a Indian theatre director and a drama teacher. He is remembered as the father of Indian theatre. Very, very important. Ibrahim Al-Qaizi is known as the father of Indian theatre. He served as the director of National School of Drama, that is NSD. It is located in New Delhi from 1962 to 1977. That is National School of Drama. He was the first person to bring the regional language plays to NSD, that is National School of Drama. He has directed over 50 plays, including Girish Karnad's Tughlaq and Dharmavir's Bharati's Anand Yug. He is also recipient of Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, and finally some Sangeet Academy Awards. With this, we can conclude our video. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Gear up for Group 1 exam. This is Sunny Sandeep signing out. Take care and bye bye.